What's up, guys? It's Blake. Welcome back to the channel. I'm actually hunting here today. It's the day after Thanksgiving, and on today's video, we're going to bring you an exciting hunt. Happened last weekend here in Kentucky. My brother Derek was able to fill his Kentucky buck tag during the rifle season on a really cool hunt. I actually have a hunt thrown air in this video as well that was on the same day on the same farm. It was pretty exciting, and some crazy things happened up here in the tree that we're excited to bring to you. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our page. Once we hit 1,000 subscribers, we're going to give away a Tacticam Reveal, brand new Tacticam Reveal camera, one of the hottest items on the outdoor market. So be sure to like this video, subscribe, comment below, let us know what you think, and let us know how your season's going. So again, I'm going to sit here a little bit longer. Hopefully we'll be able to fill my buck tag here today. But if not, we hope you enjoy the video, and we'll see you on the next one. Good morning, guys. Here we are. It's November 20th. We're on the back end of the rut here in Kentucky. I believe it's probably starting to wind down a little bit for now. Over the last week or so, a lot of these bucks have been locked down with does. And we've, as a group, between four of us, we've seen about 3 to 4 deer in about 40 hours of hunting. So it's not been the best November for us here in Aaron Outdoors. I haven't been able to take a vacation this year, so I ain't been able to hunt as much. But I'm here this morning. We're at this good rut farm that we got. We've been having some deer start moving through late morning throughout the middle of the day. But we went ahead and got settled in early this morning just to be safe, just in case one strolls through early. I killed a nice 10-pointer out of this stand last year, a little over a year ago. So we're going to sit tight here. We got a hard frost on, high pressure, right around 30 degrees. Brad and Derek are over in the bottom, a few hundred yards away from me on this creek. Thick in here, so hopefully we'll have a buck coming through here scent checking some of these bedding areas for does. Stay with us. It's Derek here. Brett and I come back down here hunting on a creek this morning. We have some turkeys up above us that's roosted. Woods are starting to wake up. It's the second weekend of modern gun season here in Kentucky, so hopefully we'll have one pass through this morning. Just stay with us. Hope to have some action for you soon. ditch. It's coming, it's coming. Okay, I couldn't see him when you shot.
I thought you done it. So...
it's alright.
You acted kind of funny.
I couldn't tell. We'll have to go back on the video and look.
Something fell out of the tree.
Something fell out of my pocket or something when I turned.
It's 8:53, and I just had a little 6-point circling around here behind me. But in other news, I just heard a shot back over towards where Derek and Brett are hunting. It was pretty loud. I jumped whenever the shot went off, but there's some neighbors that hunt not too far over that way too, so I don't know, fingers crossed that it was Derek and he made a good shot on a deer. I don't know. I didn't get any cell cam pictures of a buck over there. So, I don't know. Really, really hope we can get a buck down up here. Today, I'm hoping Derek made a good shot on whatever that was. And I'm hoping it was him, so I'm gonna be on pins and needles here for the next 10 minutes waiting to see if Derek made a shot on a buck or if that was the neighbor, so. Fingers crossed, stay tuned. I'm gonna sit tight here a little while longer.
Shot at one. I think I hit him.
What does Brett say?
Huh?
What'd Brett say?
Brett's right here. He dropped his phone out of the tree right as soon as the deer was coming through. It made a big loud noise and kind of threw us off.
Fell out of my pocket.
Come down the creek.
On your side?
Yeah.
From back, from like up that way behind?
Back behind me here.
Yeah. Which one was it?
I'm not 100% sure.
Looked like that tall.
Might have been the tall one.
Well, all right. What? Where's Brett?
He's not there.
What do you think? I have no idea. I wasn't on it when he shot.
He wasn't on it. He was not on it when I shot, he said. But he had already, he tried to stop me once. He went, meh. I couldn't get on him. He moved through all these trees.
You didn't hear a crash or nothing? No.
No.
All right, well, what do you want me to do? We need to wait a while.
Guess we need to wait a little bit.
All right, we'll give it. I don't know what time it is. What time is it?
8:57.
Well, you want to give it till 9:30? Or what?
Said chill out till 10 o'clock, probably.
10 o'clock? Okay.
He's going to see what he can see on this footage. We'll let you know.
All right. Do you feel okay about it?
Well, I mean, I was on the deer. Behind the shoulder, from what I
was he quartering away?
No, he was starting to kind of quarter away, but he was pretty broadside. But he was starting to move a little.
How far?
How far?
Yeah, how far was the shot?
40 yards, maybe.
Okay.
35, 40.
Okay. Well, all right. I'll check back with you here in a few minutes.
All right. Keep your eyes open, ears.
Okay. Hey, did he run? Did he run? Which way did he ran back the other way, though, right?
No, he ran toward your one.
Oh, okay. All right, well, we'll be quiet here, and we'll give him some time. All right, see ya.
Peace.
shot at one. Who knows what happened? Brett wasn't on the deer when Derek shot because of whatever, I don't know. It's untelling with those two. So we'll sit tight here and see what happens.
All right, guys, we've collected our thoughts here for just a little bit. It happened quick. A nice mature buck came in from my right here. Brett was actually watching a couple of fawns down here in the creek, but this buck came through trailing a doe that came through just a bit earlier. And we first tried to get him to stop down here, but as Brett made the move to try to stop the deer, his cell phone fell out of his pocket and landed on my platform of my deer stand, which is metal. Made a little bit of noise. Deer kind of stopped, but didn't really know what was going on. Then got behind, eased this way, got behind some thick stuff right here. Too thick to pull off the shot there. He finally stepped into the last shooting lane that really have here where you feel comfortable. And I squeezed off a shot. Felt confident in the shot at the time, so I pulled the trigger. But the deer took off that direction. It's pretty thick down in here at this point, so that was the last really opportunity I felt like I had. Brett said he was standing behind a tree. Unfortunately, the shot didn't get on camera, but that's the way you dealt with down here and all this thick stuff, this low-lying timber. So we're gonna give it a little bit of get down, see if we can see any evidence of a clean shot. So stay with us. It's been about an hour since I shot the deer down here just a little bit ago, so we've gave it some time. Blake's hunting another stand. He's going to make his way to us. We're going to get down and get over here to where the deer was standing when I pulled the trigger and hopefully find some sign. Just fingers crossed that we can recover this deer here shortly.
Alright. Meh.
Guys, I'm midway from climbing down out of this stand, and Derek's already on the ground, and Blake just shot. So, I don't know. It could have been a coyote, could have been a deer. I don't know, but things are getting crazy around here. Fingers crossed we got at least one deer on the ground, maybe two. Thank you, Lord. Now don't let me fall. Well, guys, the last hour and a half has been pretty crazy here in the woods. Derek had shot that buck, and Brett and him had got down and went to see for blood at the point of impact, and they said they found pretty good blood down there. So I was starting to get down. I said I was going to sit until 10 o'clock and then get down and go over there and try to help them recover that deer. And as I was putting the camera in this bag right here, and I looked to my left, and as the camera just got in the bag, a fawn took off running, and I looked to the left of her, and there was a pretty good buck. I know it had at least five on one side. Was chasing her around, so I could have probably just left the camera in the bag and got a shot off, but I wanted to get it on film, so I took the camera back out of the bag, put it back on the mount here, screwed it back in, plugged in this VeriZoom so I could maneuver the camera and focus. And by that time the deer had got up here behind me, and he was about 60, 70 yards up the hill right there. You can see it's kind of brushy, but he was right over top of a cedar limb that I could see, and I had a pretty clear shot at him. And the only thing I can think is I just rushed it. The adrenaline of everything happening fast, and I have the bag back here in my lap, and I was standing up just getting ready to get out. And of course, that's how it always works out. But I shot, and at first I for sure thought I had missed because the deer didn't move. It just stood there. And I put another bullet in the chamber. He took off and kind of trotted up and around and chased a couple more of those does around. And I never saw him move again. But the does ended up coming back down here, and a little six-pointer come in and chased them off. And they went back that way. But I never seen that buck again. I don't know if I spooked him, or I went back and watched the footage, and his belly jiggles a little bit. Right as I shoot, so it wasn't, if I did hit him, it was not a good shot. It would have been a gut or stomach shot if I hit him, which is not what you want, but I'm pretty sure I missed. And the cattle's moving in there up on top of the hill. So, I don't know. I guess I'm going to get down here in a minute and go regroup and get with the guys and try to recover Derek's deer, and then maybe see if there's anything worth trying to track on that one I shot at. Inexcusable. Shouldn't have rushed, but that's part of the thing that goes with self-filming. Trying to film with one hand, get the gun with the other. It's just, you want to make an ethical shot, and I just rushed. I just rushed the shot. Those does could have got pushed on down towards me a little bit, but I thought they were going to head up on around the hill. So anyway, we're going to lace our boots back up, get down, and stay positive. At least go try to recover Derek's buck.
All right, guys, it's about 2.5 hours after I shot that buck this morning. We got a confirmed hit. We have some hair on the ground here. We also have some blood. So got everybody here. We're going to track this deer and see if we can make a recovery here. So stay with us. And it went all the way up that way.
I saved the dead deer.
Sure hope so. Felt like it was on it good.
Alright.
Don't have any further than this. I seen him going in them them trees up there. No, we have not been any further than right there. I'm guessing he stayed on that trail. There. Maybe we can go get another one.
Yeah, I missed one. Let's go ahead and celebrate.
That deer definitely had to be dead. How's he look?
It's bigger than I thought it was too. Thank you, Jesus. That's what we asked for in the stand, wasn't it, Dad?
We walked out of that blood.
He wasn't making it far up ahead.
He bled right there, though, didn't he?
It's got good lines. Well,
we always got to make it a little interesting, it seems like. But
hold on, let me get better.
Did he tell you he dropped his phone? This deer come running through and he dropped his phone out of his pocket.
Drag him back that way a little bit.
All right, guys, we've recovered this buck here this morning. A nine pointer that Blake says we've not had on camera. I don't recognize this deer, but nonetheless, this deer came through on the trail of a doe that had came through sometime earlier. I think he was just running that same route. And he come across the little draw there. Brett tried to get him to stop. He didn't at that point, but we had an interesting moment. Brett dropped the cell phone out of his pocket, hit the platform of the tree stand, made a little bit of racket, but didn't bother this buck, didn't know what it was. He entered into a opening there that I had and pulled off a trigger 35, 40 yards, we think, thereabouts. So he didn't go 50, 60 yards probably from where I shot him. So couldn't be more happy. Bless. Good Lord has blessed us with a good buck today. And a good time, good recovery, and just happy to have one on the ground here in Kentucky.
And I missed. We think. We need to confirm. Well, as you can see, old Big D got it done this morning. Nice Kentucky whitetail here. We're just got it cleaned. Blake's taking it to the top of the hill right now. Derek had a great morning in the woods. Second weekend of rifle season here, and got one on the ground finally.
Felt good. Felt real good. A lot of activity this morning in the tree. We had turkeys all around us all morning. Very, very vocal this morning were the birds, and we had a doe come through early. A little later on, Brett saw a couple of fawns across the creek. And then later on, this big guy came tracking through, and he was looking for a doe, we believe, and able to lay down a good shot on him, recover him about 50 yards or so from where I pulled the trigger and where he hit him.
Yep, so we're going to get to the top of this hill and get to the house and get this buck skinned out. We'll see you on the next one.